gardeners, welcome back to another video on my channel. My name is Trisha and I am joined by Bloom, my plasma corn snake today, and we are going to talk about the pros and cons of corn snakes. I feel like corn snakes are very underrated and most people are just very infatuated with ball pythons, and corn snakes deserve some love because they are absolutely some of the most entertaining snakes ever. So yeah, we're gonna jump into it today and figure out if a corn snake would be a best fit for you or not. So I think I'm gonna alternate and do a pro and then a pro and then a con, because I don't want it to be too positive or too negative. I'm just gonna give you all the points and you guys can figure out for yourself whether or not you think corn snakes make good pets. I'm not gonna lie, it was really hard coming up with cons for corn snakes, but I managed to do it because they are not a good fit for everyone. So I'm gonna jump in and hopefully this video will be helpful. So the very first pro that I want to talk about with corn snakes is that they are the best eaters. They are not known to refuse a meal, and a lot of other snake species like ball pythons, they kind of go on feeding strikes, and when your animal is not eating, it is so stressful and it's really hard to figure out what the problem is and make sure that your snake is healthy. And for new keepers, that's just like such a nightmare because they just freak out. They don't know what's going on and it's just a really stressful thing to deal with. But with corn snakes, that's not something you're gonna have to deal with as long as you have a healthy corn snake. If your corn snake is refusing a meal, that's really, really abnormal and you should absolutely see a vet. But for the most part, they're just such great eaters and it makes keeping them so much easier. So the first con that I'm gonna bring up is that baby corn snakes in particular are very, very flighty. So this means that they can be a little bit more difficult when it comes to handling. They're kind of just like very sporadic and all over the place. And Bloom was like that when he was a baby too. As you can see, he's pretty calm now and he still like moves around a bit, but he's pretty slow moving and just way more laid back. So as they get older and they get used to handling, they will chill out like this. Again, it kind of depends on your snake because every snake has its own personality, but for the most part, the babies are gonna be way more flighty. And for a new keeper, that may not be something that they're into. It may freak them out and they might be worried they're gonna lose their snake or get bitten and they just aren't comfortable with the situation. So that's definitely not for everyone and it's something to be aware of. The second pro is that corn snakes are like the perfect size for a beginner getting a snake, because they're pretty skinny, as you can see, compared to like a ball python that gets very thick in girth. And corn snakes as babies are like teeny, teeny, tiny little noodles. So if you're nervous about snakes, it's great to get a snake that's very small like that. And as it grows, you'll get accustomed to it and get used to it. So it's just a really nice way to ease into snakes in general, especially if you're nervous about them. And they don't get that large either, so it's just an overall great size snake if you don't want something that's gonna get really large. The range said they get from 2 to 6 feet, which 6 feet is just like very, very large for a corn snake. I don't think you're gonna really typically be dealing with that. I would say they're typically gonna be around 3 to 5 feet. So that's just something to keep in mind because everyone has their own preferences on a size snake that they would want. Bloom is still growing. He's not full grown. I'm not sure how long he is. I never know how long any of my snakes are. I'm so sorry. I never measure them, but he's a pretty long boy, but he's still growing. Yep. He's like, what are you doing to me? I'm sorry. We need to show everyone how long you are. So yeah, as you can see, he's a pretty good size, but he's still growing. The second con for corn snakes is that these little boogers are escape artists. Like, probably the most common snake to get lost in a house. I always hear about corn snakes because these guys are just so active. They're so intelligent. They go into every nook and cranny, and you need to be very careful when keeping these guys to make sure that the tanks are locked shut, completely secure, because you don't want to lose your snake. And if there is the slightest chance of a possibility that your corn snake can get out, I guarantee it will find that way out. So you really need to be careful about that, because these guys know what they're doing and they will find their way out. So you just got to be very, very, very cautious when it comes to the security of their tanks. The third pro is that corn snakes are so entertaining and they have the best personalities. So a lot of the times when you're keeping snakes, they may not be the most entertaining. A lot of snakes are nocturnal, so they're going to be sleeping during the day, and at nighttime, some of them just aren't as active as others. And I have to say, out of all of my snakes, Bloom is by far the most entertaining and the most active. He's always out doing silly things. It's hilarious because I'll literally just like glance over at his tank and he's just like, he has his little alien head just popping out watching me all the time. It's just like the cutest, funniest thing. So they're definitely not a boring snake to keep. If you want something that's going to entertain you, that you can interact with, a corn snake is absolutely perfect for you. The third con is because these guys are so active and so entertaining, they require more space, I think, than a lot of people think for them, because they are such a small snake compared to others. I think the minimum for a corn snake is 40 gallons, and honestly, I think that that's too small for a corn snake, especially an adult. I think that they should be in the same range as like a ball python, and they should have a 75 gallon enclosure or a 4-foot by 2-foot enclosure, because they're just so active. They utilize every single part of their enclosure that you give them. So I think that it's fair to just give them the most space that you can possibly give them. Even though they're such a small snake, you may not think that, but they're just so active, so they will require a lot of space. The fourth pro is that corn snakes have a low humidity requirement. So this is a pro because for a lot of beginners in particular, they struggle with humidity requirements, and it's something that's a little bit more challenging for them. So I think it's a pro for beginners especially that they have a lower humidity requirement. Although because of that, a lot of the times people will have struggles with their shedding. So you need to make sure that when they're shedding, you're always going to want to up that humidity, even though they have a low general humidity requirement, just to make sure they're going to get a nice, healthy, full shed off. Another thing you can do is literally just supply a really large water bowl that they can just completely dip themselves in, and that will help with the shedding as well. The fourth con, as I said, it was really hard for me to come up with cons, and I asked my boyfriend, I was like, if there's any con you can come up with for Bloom, what would it be? And he knew instantly, and he said that basically he's way too loud at nighttime. And this is partially just because of what I have in my enclosure, but it is something that I guess to be aware of depending on what type of things you have in your enclosure. But because corn snakes are so active at nighttime, they can be loud. Like, I have a styrofoam background in the back of Bloom's enclosure, and he like squeezes himself through that, and it is extremely loud, especially when we're trying to sleep at night. So between that and like leaves from like the natural leaf litter on the ground from him like slithering through all of that, and just, he can be pretty loud at nighttime. So that's a con for my boyfriend, and it's like the most random one ever, but I thought I would mention it because I came up short when it came to cons for corn snakes because they're amazing. So the fifth pro for corn snakes is that they are great with handling. So as I mentioned, the babies are usually flighty, but in general, especially as adults, corn snakes are just so good with handling. They're chill. They don't typically bite. They're not like a very aggressive type of snake, but every snake is going to have its own personality. So some corn snakes may be nippy. So in general though, they're typically just laid back and not aggressive or defensive. So great for handling, and honestly that's like one of the best parts about keeping snakes is being able to handle them. So it's very relaxing. Anytime I get to take Bloom out, it feels like it's like a form of therapy. I just love handling him so much. The fifth con that I was able to come up with is, it's not even that much of a con. Okay, so it has to do with poop. All animals poop. I guess that can be a con for any animal. However, with corn snakes, they have really weird poop. Most snakes have like bigger poop. Corn snakes have tiny little poops, and they like don't look normal. They're just kind of weird, and they can be kind of hard to find in your enclosure sometimes. So I feel like that's a con. It's best if you can go bioactive, but because they have that low humidity, you need isopods that are gonna be able to establish themselves well on a low humidity enclosure, which is something I need to do more research on, so that way I can give that to Bloom, because I use springtails and the enclosure dried out and the springtails died. So I'm just left with cleaning up the mess myself and looking for his weird little poops. So that is my only other con that I could come up with for corn snakes, which is super lame. So I have one more pro when it comes to corn snakes, and that is that there are so many different varieties and morphs. I want to mention this because I feel like ball pythons are so popular because of all of the morphs that are out there, and people may not realize that corn snakes have so many morphs as well. So if that's something that intrigues you and you like the different colors and patterns, there are so many different things to choose from when it comes to corn snakes. And Bloom is attached to my dress. So he keeps getting tangled in my dress, but I'm trying to show you off. He's a plasma corn snake, and it's not really common. I believe he was a lavender mixed with a sun-kissed, and he's kind of like purplish, grayish, pinkish kind of tones, but he's beautiful. He has blue eyes too. A lot of people don't notice that. It is kind of strange because most corn snakes don't have blue eyes, but he does. So he's a pretty little guy, and there are just so many different colors and variations, different things that you can get that appeal to you. So that is definitely a pro when it comes to corn snakes. And then I don't have a sixth con because I literally had the hardest time coming up with cons for these guys. So that is all that I have for today. So I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a comment. Let me know if you can think of any pros or cons that I haven't mentioned yet about corn snakes. Do you guys keep corn snakes? I want to hear all about it because I love corn snakes. I think that more people should appreciate them because they're just such amazing, entertaining, spunky snakes, and they have so much personality. So I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you enjoyed seeing Bloom. Thank you guys for being here today, and I will see you guys in the next video.